Whoa, welcome to my Cactus Cowboy YouTube channel. My name is Dave Rose. Thanks for joining me today. I'm here in my studio surrounded by my record collection, and today I'll be showing you how I go about building shelves. All the shelving you see here is custom made out of my shop building, designed for records specifically and to fit in the space that I have available. I start with 4x8 sheets of plywood, rip them down to the proper width on my radial arm saw, and then I'll cut dado joints, fit all the pieces together, and assemble it with a pneumatic brad gun and wood glue. We'll go through that process and I will show you how it's done. Well, here we go. Switching the saw blade on the radial arm saw. Notice this is left-hand thread. Normally tighten, you'd go righty tighty, lefty loosey. Completely the opposite here. All right. Okay, so my vertical dividers are quarter inch plywood. There's a little bit of paint on them, so I've got to adjust this for quarter inch. I'm going to make some cuts and I might have to adjust this, but get right about here, quarter inch on the dado blade. Rotation this way, rotation this way. Okay, so don't need the spacer for the dado blade. I'm gonna put that on and remember, righty tighty, lefty loosey. Lefty loosey is actually tightening. There we go. Okay, got the dado blade on. Got a piece of scrap here. We're gonna lower it down. We're gonna have to check the width of the cut and the depth of the cut. I want a fairly shallow cut with this dado. All right, let's give it a shot. Okay, the best way to test this, here's my dado cut, and here's quarter inch. Does it fit? Yeah, nice. Not too much wiggle, not too much slop. Fits in there easily, that's good. That's what we want. Okay, wasn't happy with eighth of an inch depth on that. Here's a 16th of an inch. I think that's better because these cuts are going to be on both sides of the wood, and it's got to be strong enough. There's got to be enough meat left in the wood so that it's not going to break. But that's enough of a groove that the divider pieces will fit in nicely, and we'll get them glued in. They'll be snug. So I've got 12 pieces. These are 95 and 5/8 inches long. I had to cut them slightly to accommodate for the dado joints in the side pieces because I want my backing board, which is 96 and a quarter inches wide, to fit exactly. So I've got these 12 pieces, 95 and 5/8 inches, and I need to cut dado joints for the vertical dividers. There's going to be 7 dividers in each piece, and my first step is going to be get dead center and cut the dados for all 12 pieces dead center, and then I'll use stops on the radial arm saw table to cut dados 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 for both sides. So I'll have 7 dividers overall for an 8-foot wide shelf. The importance of the vertical dividers is twofold. One, you want to provide rigidity and support to the entire shelf unit, and secondly, you don't want a row of LPs 2 or 3 feet long leaning over and against each other. You need vertical dividers every 12 to 15 inches to provide that support side to side so they don't lean against each other. Anyway, we'll get going on the 12 horizontal pieces. I'm going to make a series of dado cuts in these boards with the radial arm saw. Notice I've got a stop here. That's so I can butt the board up against here and I get consistent measurement and accuracy from one piece to the next. Okay, we're making dado cuts in the wood. Well, cheers. Time for a beer break. No question that having a radial arm saw to do this job makes it faster, easier, and more accurate. It is possible to do this with a handheld circular saw and straight edges, but it's a lot more time consuming and it's more difficult to get fast, accurate, and clean cuts. One thing that's vital, whether you're using a radial arm saw or handheld, make sure everything is absolutely dead on square. If you're slightest bit off, it's going to cause you immense frustration when you put everything together. Okay, I've made all the dado cuts in all the pieces of wood, 150 dado joints in all. These 4 pieces are the end pieces, the vertical ends to the shelves. And they are cut with a 1/2 inch groove to accept the horizontal 1/2 inch pieces. Over here we've got all the 1/2 inch horizontal pieces. These 4 pieces are top and bottom of the shelves, and you'll notice they are cut on one side only. And these are the intermediate or middle shelves, and they are cut on both sides to accept the 1/4 inch plywood vertical dividers. Okay, for the assembly process, I'm going to use a pneumatic brad gun. Got 1 3/8 inch staples, and I've got the tool pressure set to 100 psi. Now you notice I've got the milk crate here to make sure everything's square. I cut these pieces out of scrap plywood and they are going to be tacked on here. They're only temporary, but the purpose of them is to make sure these corners are square and hold everything in position as I assemble. Driving the nails in only part way so I can get them out easily. But this will help provide stability to the shelves as they're being assembled. Without this step, if I move this thing around, as I'll have to, it's going to pull the staples out and just be a mess. Okay, got all the horizontal pieces in place, top, bottom, middle shelves. Now I've got to put on the other end. $1 million question, is it square? Easiest and fastest way to check is to measure from one corner to the other, and then measure from the other corner to the other. Had to do a little tweaking, but yes, now it is perfectly square. So I'm gonna nail in a couple more corner braces to stabilize it. Well, here's the first of 35 vertical dividers for this shelf unit, glued and clamped in place. Here's the glue I'm using, Elmer's Carpenter's Wood Glue. Getting more of the vertical dividers in place. It's always good to have a lot of clamps. Well, here we go. Got all of the dividers in. This unit is ready to flip over and put the backing on. Incidentally, this is only half of the shelving. There's going to be two shelves, same size as this, back to back. Now, I don't like putting shelving units directly on the floor. I like to make a base for them. So here's a base that I made out of 2x4s, ripped down and cut dado joints and glued in cross pieces. So this will sit on the floor and the two shelving units, one here and one here, back to back, will sit on this. Okay, I've got 1/8 inch hardboard on the back of this shelving unit. This is pretty much essential for strength and rigidity. Some of you folks might have those IKEA Kallax shelves, which are basically particle board. If you do go that route, strongly suggest you get some hardboard such as this and put it onto the back of those shelves. It will dramatically increase the rigidity and the strength of the unit. So this is almost done. All I need to do is some touch-up paint on this unit. Build the other unit, it's twins. Well, just to give you an idea of size, this is sitting on its end, by the way. This measures 70 by 96 inches overall. Well, here we are in the studio. We've got this on the base. Here's the one completed unit in place. The other unit, same size, needs to be built. Once that's built, I'll bring that in and attach it to this side. Here it is. Second half of the shelving unit in place, both units secured to each other. They're on a 2x4 base. Got 40 running feet of shelf space on each side, 80 feet total. Figuring about 70 LPs per running foot, this will hold about 5,600 albums. Weight, probably close to a ton and a half. In case you're wondering, the floor is a concrete slab and the weight of the records is not really an issue. Anyway, that's how I make my shelves. I hope you picked up some good tips here. This is a nice alternative, designing and building custom shelves to fit your space. Well, thanks for watching. Be sure to check out my other YouTube videos.